Good morning, student. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So these symmetrical components in terms of phase currents. So I think we have started this discussion in the last class. Yes or no? The last class?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this symmetrical component, basically we have the positive sequence component, then negative sequence component and zero sequence component. So we know that this three sequence component, it constitutes the any phase current. So IR equal to IR1, that is the positive sequence current, plus negative IR2 is the negative sequence current, and IR0 is the zero sequence current. Then IY is similarly IY1 plus IY2 plus IY0, and IB equal to IB1 plus IB2 plus IB0. Now, this particular part we have discussed in last class, that how the sequence component will come. So IR1 equal to, this is IR1. So normally the rotation of A vector is, it is in the anti-clockwise, and the phasor rotation of this positive sequence component, it is in the clockwise direction. So this is IR1, this is IY1, and this is IB. Okay. So when we are multiplying A, so this becomes A into IR1, and then it is A square, so A square into IR1. So let us say, okay. So this is your, for example, so this is your IR1. So as it is a positive sequence component, so phasor rotation will be in the clockwise direction. This is IY1, and this is your IB1. Now we know the direction. So phasor rotation of positive sequence network, it is in the clockwise direction, but the rotation of A vector, that is A operator basically, it is in the anti-clockwise direction. So this will be when we are multiplying. So this angle is 120 degree. This is 120 degree. So if you multiply A with IR1, we'll get IB1. So we'll get A into IR1. Similarly, if again you are this angle between IB1 and IY1, this is also 120 degree. So if you multiply A square with IR1, so you will get IY1. So this is your A square into IR1. So this is your positive sequence network. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now we'll come to the negative sequence component. So let us say this is your IR1. Now in the negative sequence component, the phasor rotation will be in the clockwise or it will be anti-clockwise? Phasor rotation?
Anti-clockwise.
Huh? Clockwise. Negative sequence. See, I will explain once again. For positive sequence phasor rotation is clockwise, whereas for a negative sequence phasor rotation is anticlockwise. Now the A operator positive and negative, both will be in the anticlockwise direction. Is it clear now? Okay.
Yes.
So if for the negative sequence network, so this is your negative sequence network. This is your negative sequence network. Now, negative sequence network, phasor rotation will be in the anticlockwise direction. This will be IY1 and this will be your IB1. Now angle between this and this is 120 degree. So if you multiply A with IR1, you will get IY1. So this is your A into IR1. Similarly, if you again multiply 120 degree, so this is 240 degree. So 240 degree means we have to multiply by A square. So if you multiply A square with IR1, you will get IB1. So this is your A square into IR1. Now we'll come to the zero sequence component. Zero sequence component, we know that this will be basically a parallel kind of thing. So there is no phase. So in this case, this is your IR1, this is your IR1, then this is your IY1, and this is your IB1. So all are parallel. Okay. Is it clear? This one, and so what is positive and what is negative sequence network? And this is your basically zero sequence network. This is your zero. This is zero sequence network. Clear? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So the same thing is shown here. Whatever I have drawn, that is here, is shown. So we can write IR equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR0. Now IY equal to IY1 plus IY2 plus IY0. Now IY1 equal to, just now I have written, what is IY1? This is A square into IR1 and IB1 is A into IR1. So the same thing is written here, A square into IR1 plus A into IR2 plus IR0. Now here, this because IR0 equal to IY0 equal to IB0, zero sequence component all are equal. Similarly, IB equal to IB1 plus IB2 plus IB0. Okay, so this will be A into IR1 plus A square into IR2 plus IR0. Is it clear? This three equation, or should I explain once again? Equation is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now zero sequence current, IR plus IY plus IB, we know this is how we are going to derive. So IR1, this will be equal to IR1 into 1 plus A into A square plus A, and IR2 into 1 plus A plus A square, and this is 3 IR0. So if you add these three, if you add these three, so this will be basically, so I should derive in the somewhere there. Facing something problem with the Zoom. Okay, so IR equal to what? This is IR1 plus IR2 plus IR0. So IR1 equal to what? In the last slide we have shown. So this is IR1, IY1 equal to A square into IR1, and this is A into IR1. Okay. So this will be IR1, this is equal to A square into, sorry, IR1 is this one, I think. IR1, then IB1 and IY1. So we have 3 days. So IY equal to your IY1 plus IY2 plus IY0. Okay. Now here, this IY1 equal to your A square into IR1, and this IY2, you see, what is IY2? IY2 is, this one is IY2. Okay, this is IY2. Sorry, here I have written 1 instead of that. This should be 2. All will be 2. This will be 2, because it is negative sequence. Huh? So this will be all 2. Okay. So this will be A into IR2. So A into IR2. This will be A into IR2. And we know IY0 equal to your IR0. Similarly, IB equal to, we know, IB1 plus IB2 plus IB0. Now, what is IB1? So, IB1 equal to A into IR1 and IB2 equal to A square into IR2. Okay. So, IB1 will be A into IR1, and this will be A square into IR2, and this will be simple IR0. So IR plus IY plus IB, this will be equal to, we are taking common IR1, so this will be 1 plus A square plus A, and this will be again IR2, we are taking common. So this will be again 1 plus A plus A square, and this will be your 3 into IR0. Now we know 1 plus A plus A square equal to how much? 1 plus A plus A square equal to how much?
0.
So this term, the these two component will vanish. These two component will vanish. This will be zero. So this is your 3 into IR naught. So that means IR naught will be equal to 1/3 of IR plus IY plus IB. So zero sequence component equal to basically 1/3 of IR plus IY plus IB. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Facing today some problem on Zoom. I don't know what is happening. Okay, now slide is visible?
No, sir.
Just a minute. Hello?
Slide is not visible, sir.
Class has just a minute. Okay, so this is it visible now?
Yes, sir. Now it is visible.
So I zero equal to basically 1/3 of IR plus IY plus IB. Okay. Now next is, yeah, I'm facing today problem on Zoom. I don't know what is happening. Scroll this slide. I will not make full slide. I will make this way. So is it visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Because if I am making full slide, then there is a problem. Okay. Okay, fine. We'll continue with this today. Now see the positive sequence current. Now we are going to calculate the positive sequence current. So what we are going to do, this IR plus A into IY plus A square into IB. So in this case, you know this IR, IY and IB, these equations are known to you. So if you multiply this thing, that is IR plus A into IY plus A square into IB. So what will happen? Simple, this IR1 into 1 plus A cube plus A cube plus this will be IR2 into 1 plus A square plus A to the power 4. So should I derive it? Should I derive now?
Yes. No, sir.
Huh? Someone is telling yes. So should I derive? I don't know. If you tell, then I will go to the board. Okay. Basically, here IR1, this whatever is there, that is for IR1, means IR plus A into IY plus A square into IB. So what will happen, you see, 1 plus a plus a square, this becomes 0. Then 1 plus a square, this is a to the power 4. So a cube equal to how much? A cube equal to 1. So into a, that means a to the power 4 equal to basically a. Now this 1 plus a square plus a equal to 0. So this term will come. A cube equal to 1, this A cube equal to 1, so this will be 3 times. So 3 into IR1, so IR1 will be equal to 1 third of IR plus A into IY plus A square into IB. Just a minute, I will. Okay, could you please tell me what are the equations there? Somebody is facing problem, I should derive them. IR1 equal to what? That is IR1 plus IR2 plus, sorry, IR equal to, this is IR equal to. IR equal to plus IR0. Now IY equal to, what was that? A square into IR1. Yes or no? Plus A into IR2. Plus IR0. Yes or no? Please, if I, you correct me. Is correct or wrong?
Correct, sir.
Correct, na? So now what we'll do? This will multiply IR plus AIY plus A square into IB. Okay, that thing we'll do. So, IR plus A into IY plus A square into IB. Okay. So, this will be IR 1. Plus IR2 plus IR0, then A into AY, so this will be A square into IR1 plus A into IR2 plus IR0, and this will be your IB equal to A square into A into IR1 plus A square into IR2 plus IR0. Now we'll do the simplification. So we are taking common IR1. So this will be 1, this will be one, A into A square, that means this will be A cube, and here also plus A cube, then IR2, this is 1, so IR2 means this will be A square, this and this are multiplied, this will be A square, now here A square plus this A square, this becomes A to the power 4, and then plus IR0, so IR0, this will be 1. And this IR0, this is A, and here it will come, IR0 means A square. Okay, so this term will be 0, yes or no? This term will be 0, 1 plus A plus A square, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now A cube equal to 1, this is property of this A operator, and A to the power 4, we have to remember, this is A cube into A. So 1 into A, that is equal to A. So that means IR1 equal to, this A cube equal to 1, this is plus 1. Then IR2, this is 1 plus A square, this A to the power 4 equal to A. Okay, now this term is again 0. So finally we are getting 3 times of IR1. So IR1 equal to 1 third of IR plus A into IY plus A square into IB. Yes or no? Clear? Any doubt?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
Okay. Fine. Now let me share that thing. Okay. So this is, we are getting IR1 equal to this one. So IR1, sometimes it is written I1. Okay. Now negative sequence current, similar way, that is IR plus A square into IY plus A into IB. Now in this case, IR1, should I derive this thing? It is similar way. It is similar way. Okay. In this case, we have multiplied A into IY. Here it is A square into IY. Here it is A square into IB. It is A into IB. I should derive it. Na? Okay. I think you require that thing. That's why you are silent. Okay. So this. Now we'll do this thing, that is IR, sorry, this is IR plus A square into IY plus A into IB. So IR equal to IR naught plus IR1 plus IR2. This is A square, but here it will be your IY. So IY equal to A square into IR1. So this will be A square into IR1 plus A into IR2 plus IR0. Okay. And here IB equal to A into IR1 plus A into IR1 plus A square into IR2 plus IR0. So now we'll do the simplification. So IR0, this is 1 plus IR0 means this will be A square and this will be A. So this is IR0. Then IR1, this will be 1, and this will be A to the power 4, and this will be IR1, so this will be A square. Now plus IR2, so IR2, this is 1, plus this will be A into A square, that is A cube, and then IR2, this is A square into A, so that is A cube. Okay. So this term will be 0. Okay. Here A cube equal to what? A cube equal to? Sorry, A to the power 4 equal to?
A.
So A square in A cube into A. So that means what? A. So I am writing once again IR1 plus A1 plus A plus A square. And this will be your A cube means 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 1. It is 3. So 3 into IR2. So this term will be equal to 0. So IR2 will be equal to 1 third IR plus A square into IY plus A into IB. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So we are basically deriving all the sequence component network in terms of phase current. So the same thing we have got, IR2 equal to 1 third into IR plus A square into IY plus A into IB. So the points, following points may be noted carefully. So the currents I1, I2 and I0 are the symmetrical component of R phase. Because of the symmetry of each set, the symmetrical components of yellow and blue phases can be easily known. Okay, that is the clear cut thing. Now next is, although the treatment has been made considering currents, the method applies equally to the voltages. So whatever we have done, that we have shown for the current, but the similar thing, similar formula, same formula is applicable for the voltages. Okay, we have not shown that thing for the voltages, but it is equally true for the voltages. So E0 equal to your 1 third into ER plus EY plus EB, and E1 equal to 1 third into ER plus A into EY plus A square into EB. And E2 equal to 1 third ER plus A square into EY plus A into EB. So whatever we have done for the current, the same replica is there for the voltages. So there will not be any change. So now the some facts around the sequence components we need to know. This, what are the different facts based on this? So it is now desirable to get the readers acquainted with the following facts about the positive, negative and zero sequence current. First is that a balanced three-phase system consists of the positive sequence components only, the negative and zero sequence components being zero. So we have seen for the symmetrical analysis, there was no sequence component. But if you actually analyze that thing in a symmetrical fault analysis, only positive sequence component will be there, negative sequence and zero sequence component will be zero. Is it clear for the balanced system? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, the presence of negative or zero sequence current in a three-phase system introduces unsymmetry, and it is indicative of an abnormal condition of the circuit in which these components are found. So basically, for the unbalanced system, what we are actually dealing now, for the unbalanced system, this particular sequence component, that is the negative and zero sequence components, will be present as well as the positive sequence component. And this is basically making this network a kind of symmetrical network. Third is that the vector sum of the positive and negative sequence currents of an unbalanced three-phase system is zero. The resultant solely consists of these three sequence currents, that is, the zero sequence component, vector sum of all sequence current in a three-phase unbalanced system, that is the zero sequence component, will be IR0 plus IY0 plus IB0. Next, in a three-phase four-wire unbalanced system, the magnitude of zero sequence component is one-third of the current in the neutral. So we know that zero sequence current equal to one-third of current in the neutral wire. Why? We have already derived that zero sequence current equal to one-third plus IR plus IY plus IB. So that is the basically phase current. And IR plus IY plus IB equal to your neutral current. Okay. So that's why it is one-third of the neutral current. So in the absence of the path through the neutral of a three-phase system, the neutral current is zero and the line current contains no zero sequence component. Now, connected system, we know there is no neutral component. In a delta connected system, there is no concept of the neutral. So a delta connected load provides no path to the neutral and the line current flowing to the delta connected load can contain no zero sequence component. So if it is asked that what is the zero sequence component of a delta connected system, so the answer will be what? For a delta connected system?
Sir, there is no neutral.
There is no neutral. So there is no concept of zero sequence current. So zero sequence current will be absent. Now in a three-phase unbalanced system, the magnitude of negative sequence components cannot exceed that of the positive sequence component. And if the negative sequence components were the greater, the phase sequence of the resultant system would be reversed. So you have to remember that the magnitude of the positive sequence network is highest, then that your magnitude of the negative sequence current, and then the zero sequence current. So obviously, it is not possible that the magnitude of the negative sequence will be greater than the magnitude of the positive sequence. Then the current of a single phase load drawn from a three-phase system comprises equal positive, negative, and zero sequence components. Now we'll take some numerical example. So first numerical example is, in a three-phase four-wire system, the currents in R, Y, B phases are IR equal to 100 angle 30 degree, IY equal to 50 angle 300 degree, and IB equal to 30 angle 180 degree. Calculate the positive, negative, and zero sequence current in a R line and the return current in the neutral wire. So you are supposed to calculate what is the value of positive sequence, negative sequence, and zero sequence current. And also you have to calculate what is the current in the neutral wire. So we know that this formula we have to apply, I naught equal to one third into IR plus IY plus IB. This formula, it is known to you, na? I naught equal to one third IR plus IY plus IB?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And I1 equal to one third IR plus A into IY plus A square into IB. Just now we have done this thing. And I2, that is a negative sequence current, this is one third into IR plus A square into IY plus A into I. So what has to be done? It is given in the problem, IR, IY and IB values are given. So what you have to do, you have to substitute this value. So then you have to do the simplification basically. This is in the form of r theta form. Now you have to convert this thing in a Cartesian form. So then you simplify it and you will get in a polar form, that is r theta form. So same thing you have to do. Here a value, you have to remember a value is 1 angle 120 degree. So 1 angle 120 degree and here a square is 1 angle minus 120 degree. Or you can write plus 240 degree. That is also equally true. So then you have to do the simplification and then you have to find out that is in the r theta form. Similar calculation you have to do for the I2 also. Now the current in the neutral wire, that will be equal to IR plus IY plus IB. So you have to add it and you will get the current in the neutral wire. Okay, so that is the basically numerical problem. So what has to be done? You will just, you solve from your side. Okay, I'll be taking your attendance in meanwhile. So you just solve this problem. Okay, I'm preparing for the your so you just do the calculation. You just check. A QR code is visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, please put your attendance now. Is it over? Is it over? All of you have given? No one is left?
Okay. Completed, sir.
Completed, fine. So I should stop share this thing now. Next is, okay, so this problem is over. Now we'll take another problem. Calculate the currents in a three-phase unbalanced systems are IR equal to 12 plus J6 ampere, IY equal to 12 minus J12 ampere, IB equal to minus 15 plus J10 ampere. The phase sequence is RYB. Calculate zero, positive and negative sequence components of current. So IR, IY and IB is given. So previously it was given in R theta form. Now this is given in X plus JY form. That means in the Cartesian coordinates. Okay. So here you see the same thing you have to apply. That is IR0 equal to 1/3 into IR plus IY plus IB. IR1 equal to 1/3 into IR plus A into IY plus A square into IB. And IR2 equal to 1/3 IR plus A square into IY plus A into IB. So if you do this thing, if you substitute, then you will get the values. So the zero phase sequence components will be IY0 equal to IR0. Positive sequence component will be your IY1 equal to I square into IR1. And negative sequence component will be IY2 equal to A into IR2. So if you do this calculation, you will get it. Then for the blue phase, this will be IV0 equal to that. This will be same. Zero sequence component will not be changed. All are equal. But IV1 equal to A square into IR1. So that is the positive sequence component. for the blue phase, that is S square into IR1, and IV2, this is S square into IR2. So this, if you calculate, so you will get this value. Okay, this is clear. Any doubt? Any doubt from anyone? You need to practice it. Okay. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. So now we'll close this thing, and the next class we'll meet. So I'll close this meeting. Okay. Thank you. I'll close. Any question from anyone?
No, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you.